Hello and welcome back. This is Neil Honeycomb. Thanks for joining me. The question I have is, why does geofoam work and why is the zero net loading so important? Well, you know, I'm going to put out my paper and tell you as serious as I can, because people don't necessarily believe me until they see it and they hear from other people that have used the foam, like the Department of Transportation and other road builders and bridge builders. But there's something called zero net loading, okay? What the term means is if you take expanded polystyrene geofoam or EPS geofoam and you put down a layer of it on the ground, okay? It's usually put down where there's soft and unstable soil conditions. Now, if you can imagine you have all the soft soil, this muck, and you put geofoam down on it. Once you put the first layer down, when you put the second and third and fourth and fifth layer of foam on top of it, the underlying soil doesn't feel that weight, okay? It's just, I promise you, that's the truth. It's just how the foam performs. And the only way I can really explain it is if you can imagine putting that first layer down and you put 10 layers of foam, now you take a tremendous amount of weight. You take, you know, thousands and thousands of tons worth of dirt and you dump it on there on purpose to overload the design. By the way, there's never been one geofoam project that have failed because of the foam. It's always been because of the design was made bad. And that I've seen because of the design that was done wrong. It wasn't the foam that failed. The foam has certain properties and it works all the time. But if you design it wrong, that's not good. And that's why I need a good designer. I have a good designer. But anyway, if you take, on purpose, you take more weight than the foam will hold, and you force the weight on top of the foam, what the way the foam actually works is it collapses from the top down. The first block of foam on the top where the weight is will start collapsing first, and then the second, and then the third layer, all the way down. But if you, let's say you put 10 layers of blocks of foam and you collapse all the way down to the first layer on the bottom, if you test the location of the soil underneath that first block, you will see that the foam is, the ground does not move. The ground did not move. And it's just amazing because that's what zero net loading is. That doesn't matter what weight you put on top of the foam, the underlying soil does not feel it. And that's why it is the perfect material for lightweight fill material for soft soil conditions, soft and unstable soil conditions. It works 95% of the time. No, it works 100% of the time, but it saves money 95% of the time. So that's what zero net loading is. You don't have to believe me, but it's the truth. And this is neilhoneycomb.com. Check it out for yourself. Go to epsfoampro.com for more videos and pictures. And this is Neil Honeycomb signing out. I'll see you on the next video.